Welcome back to the Macworld booth, high atop Macworld Expo. We're here on Saturday. I'm Chris Breen from Macworld, and I am joined by the general manager of Macworld Expo, Mr. Paul Kent.
Hi, Chris.
Thanks for being here.
My pleasure.
Okay, I have to tell a story. We're in the Macworld All-Star Band together.
Yes.
Tuesday night we had rehearsal.
We did.
I drove you back up to the city.
Yep.
You were a little tense.
Oh, you say?
You were just a little tense. I saw you Thursday when the show floor opened about 4 o'clock, and you look like you do now. All smiles, relaxed. This worked.
I appreciate you saying that, Chris. I do. I agree. This worked.
Yeah. And I think it's, you know, everybody, naturally, Apple backs out. For the last year, we've been talking about Macworld Expo. What's going to happen with Expo? Will it exist? It certainly was going to exist, but I think a lot of people said yes, but will it be the same thing? Will it be Boston all over again?
Yeah.
And I know you did everything you could, but certainly Tuesday night, you must have been wondering, okay, I've done what I can, but.
Yeah, well, I'll tell you, it's been an interesting year. The main premise, you know, I've been involved with Macworld for a long time, and I've been running the whole show for the past 5 years. And the one thing that I truly believe is this basic concept that people come to Macworld to find cool stuff is a wonderful proposition for us to keep going on, right? You know, Apple's presence was good, you know, helpful, certainly created a international buzz, but we were tangential to those efforts, right? You know, we still had to operate our business through the years, and the three things that we do when we build a Macworld, Apple does their own thing, is we want product discovery, you know, put buyers and sellers together, developers and users, education, we run these great conferences, and then this very important, very vital vibe, you know, this social vibe.
Right.
People come here to maintain acquaintances, to maintain relationships, all the social stuff, the, you know, breakfast, lunches, dinners, parties, all that type of stuff, it's very important to a lot of people. And we knew all three of those things were things that we have always controlled in the past, and I think we've done a very good job on it. You know, Macworld is a 26th year of Macworld. And while I understand the cloud of confusion that was caused by Apple making their announcement, I truly believed, and I believed it all year, that the three things that we promised we could deliver to people, that we could do a really good job for it. And I think what you have here is a very content-rich, you know, between free and paid stuff going on, event, very interesting. The mix of products on the show floor is really fantastic, and the social stuff is in high gear. I mean, everybody's exhausted here. We are Saturday morning.
Yeah.
Everybody's pooped because they're just going nonstop. And the best thing is, I asked you this, how's it going? It feels like Macworld.
Yeah.
That's the best compliment I could have. That's what we strove for, to bring back that feeling, you know, that was just this great vibe. It's built into what we do. It's built into this marketplace. It's built into the vibe of this community. All we had to do is give it a reason to flourish, and I think that's what we've accomplished here.
Yeah, and what I found interesting is that I've talked to a lot of vendors, and they're very happy because, and I think this is what we had predicted for a while, is that Apple tends to overshadow everything for the first couple of days. But we have Boink software here that's running our video.
Yep.
They're thrilled because they're like top 10 booths that people are going by.
Yes.
I've talked to other vendors and they say, or even the iPhone area, those guys don't stop talking all day. So for vendors, I think that the ones that are here, this is a real win because they're getting a lot of attention.
Absolutely. So, you know, the ones that are here are getting a lot of attention. And I think the story of Macworld unfolds like this. We knew that the audience wanted Macworld. And I understand there was a healthy skepticism by the developer community, but we've blown that out of the water. I mean, like you said, out of the park. There's so many people here. It's so dense. It's been 3 to 4 people deep for, you know, the past 2.5 days. I think a lot of those, about 200 exhibitors that are traditional Macworld exhibitors over the years, have seen what we've done. We've taken a lot of meetings in the sales office, and they're going to start coming back. I'm going to somewhat boldly predict that I think we'll see twice the number of exhibitors next year to this year, and then we'll just be back to, it's Macworld. It's January.
Right.
This is what we do. No more confusion. Will it? Won't it? You know, I understand where it came from.
Sure.
And I'm very gratified that we could deliver something that made everybody so happy. Now it's time to move forward, and let's get back to the to all the news about the show being about the show, not about will the show or won't the show.
Right. Well, absolutely. I was at CES last month before coming here. I saw a lot of vendors who normally go to Macworld, and I said, are you coming to Macworld? And there was a healthy number of them that said, you know, we're going to sit out this year and see what happens.
Yeah.
I think their argument now, that's gone.
Absolutely.
I mean, I don't know what your numbers are, and maybe you don't yet either, but there are a lot of people here.
There's a lot of people here. The size of the show, the density of the show, right? You know, I would be careful about getting into any kind of a this year versus last year numbers. I mean, the show's smaller,
which
is fine, but can you see all the people who have come to your booth that are here this year? So absolutely not, right?
Right.
Literally four deep at just about every booth for the past 2.5 days. So those exhibitors, I think, will be coming back. I think that they, by and large, were rooting for us. You know, they just didn't want to be too exposed this year, which is a totally fair position for them to take.
Right.
And this, we have 600 members of the press here. Truly, the worldwide Apple products press loves Macworld.
Yeah.
They get to see everything in one place at one time, one business trip, and they get tons of stuff done. Most of the news outlets here have gotten coverage, you know, stories that will take them for 3 months of content that they'll be able to release. All the new products. Yeah. We've got so many new product announcements here. So I think that the marketplace has spoken, and now the exhibitors will start stepping up. I'm fully confident of this, and we're going to have a great show next year.
Yeah. Now, without looking like I'm sucking up too much, I have to say I ran into a guy yesterday who had come from London, and he said, you know, I was kind of here because I felt like I should be here. I was afraid there wouldn't be enough to do, that I'd walk around the show floor. He said, I can't see everything that's here. And not specifically about the show floor, but he said, there's so many presentations yes. that I want to go to and conference sessions I want to go to, and I can't. And I guess I didn't plan my time well enough, but I can only spend 10 minutes going to see Pogue because then I have to run off to see this conference.
Yeah.
Are you getting that kind of feedback
Absolutely.
From people?
Absolutely. You know, we try and give as much of a rich experience as we can. So, you know, we had 7 feature presentations, you know, David Pogue, Kevin Smith, the filmmaker, Leo Laporte had an amazing panel. We have BT, the electronic artist, is going now. We're doing our special iPad event later this afternoon. Lots of things to do, and then lots of show floor to see. And so that's, you know, one of the things that's the best criticism I can have is that there was too much, right?
Right.
Because, you know, you do have to make a couple of choices, but at the end of the day, they're all degrees of good. It's vanilla or chocolate, not, you know, not garbage. And
right. Now, I know that you're a nice, gracious man. And, however, you know, a couple of months leading up to this, there were a few people in the press and on Twitter who were kind of saying, well, this is it. End of Macworld. Bye-bye. Best of luck.
Yes.
Do you feel any tiny shred of vindication that...
I mean, absolutely. It's the best thing is that this feels like Macworld.
Yeah.
You know, that is the best thing. However, it's been a tough year. We've taken a lot of bullets this year.
Yeah.
You know, a lot of skepticism. You know, there's been press that people who never understood Macworld anyway, they don't come anyway, or
right.
they only came to cover Apple and they left. I wouldn't expect much different from them. I'd like them to be fair. Some of them have been, some of them have pre-written stories. I was disappointed that there were some people in our own industry and marketplace, and one guy actually, I think, said that the show might be a disaster, right? And this is a guy who should know better, but he didn't do his homework, and, you know, I think his credibility is damaged sincerely because of this. And, there's some vindication there.
Yeah, good. So, highlights of the show for you?
The first highlight was when that stream of people were coming down the escalator and we knew it was going to be okay Tuesday morning,
yeah.
right? Excuse me, Thursday morning. You know, and then it's the vibe. That's the highlight. You know,
yeah.
it's like we're trying to capture that magic, that, you know, very intangible thing that you really can't plan on. You try and do a bunch of cool stuff and you throw it on the wall and you hope people will like it. But I'm glad that we brought a lot of business to these exhibitors who stuck with us and, you know, believed in the show and were willing to be the ones that kind of led the way here. And we will always do everything we can to support these exhibitors who are our customers, right?
Great.
I think attendees have loved the quality of the education. I think I like this concept of doing feature presentations that are varied. Mm-hmm. You know, I like that we're going to entertain people as well as inform people. I mean, I thought Gruber was fantastic the other day.
Yeah.
Very insightful. But I liked having Kevin Smith because people were laughing and having a good time. So we're turning the corner on the vibe that Macworld gives. I've been using the term fan fest because the vibe is very similar to a Comic-Con type of thing,
right.
Star Trek convention type of thing.
Right.
We are all under this roof, technology-loving people, Apple product-loving people to a great degree, and that we could just deliver something that made people this happy is really the most gratifying thing at all. So. There's no one highlight. I think at the end of the day, we delivered a great Macworld that delivered what everybody needed to get out of it. And we put ourselves in a position to grow the show, get back on track of just saying, it's January, it's Macworld time.
Cool. Okay, so when is the next Macworld Expo?
January 25th through 29th, right here at the Moscone. We'll be all in West next year, all 3 floors of West.
Oh, okay. Excellent.
Yep.
Well, thanks very much, Paul. You've done a fantastic job,
I
and I've just
it,
had
Chris.
A great time this week.
Cool. We'll do it
all
again.
Right. All right.